You've got a Mavic 2 and want to know how to easily update the firmware using one of the two ways possible? We'll show you how, coming right up. Hey, what's up? Felix here with Quadcopter Guide, bringing you the best drone guides, reviews, and tips. On this channel, we do a lot of guides and tutorials just like this one, so if you're new here, consider subscribing. And hey, anytime during the video, check out the show notes and links in the YouTube description below. We'll list all the important links and the various gear used right down there. But today, I will show you how to update the firmware on the Mavic 2. Why update the firmware? Well, perhaps you've just received your brand new Mavic 2. No, but seriously, it could have sat around in a warehouse for some time, or maybe it's been sitting at a dealer, or maybe you even purchased it used. You never know what version's on there, so it's a good idea to at least take a look. Maybe you're looking forward to some of the new features that got released with a new version. What exactly got released when, with what version, you can find out in the release notes, link below. When should you and when shouldn't you update the firmware? You should definitely not update your drone's firmware if you have a really important flight coming up and you need the drone to work as it does right now. Trust me, it's better just to take your time. All right, so you don't have any critical or important flights planned. You have time to go through the settings and make sure that they are what you expect them to be. And you have time to do a test flight outside in the wild. Then you're good to go. You can update the firmware. How do you update the firmware? There are several components to updating the firmware. One, the DJI Go app on your smartphone, the firmware obviously on the drone, but also the firmware on the remote control. And there's two ways to do this. You can update using the DJI Go app on your smartphone, or you can use the DJI Assistant 2 on a PC or Mac. And for using the DJI Assistant 2 app, you obviously need a PC or a Mac and a USB-C cable to connect the drone to the computer. There are several advantages to using the DJI Assistant 2 on your computer to update the firmware. One, you can choose which specific firmware version you want to upgrade to. You don't always have to go to the latest like you do if you use the smartphone DJI Go app. Two, you can export logs from the drone or the remote control so you can see what happened during a flight, or you can upload it to one of the analysis websites. Three, you can calibrate your drone and all the sensors. And four, you can use a simulator as you can with a smartphone using your computer. Ensure that your battery for your drone and the remote control are charged at least 50%. If the battery drops low enough, it actually will keep you from updating. And you definitely don't want your drone battery to die when it's writing brand new files to the firmware on the drone. All right, let's jump into the steps to follow for each of those two ways that I've described. And after, the most important thing, what to do after the firmware update. First up, using the DJI Go app on your smartphone. Go ahead and hook up your smartphone to the remote, power on the remote, and power on the drone. We'll fire up the DJI Go 4 app, but first, let's get that screen oriented the right way. Ooh, that was smooth as butter. If the camera view opens automatically, just tap DJI on the top left corner to get back to this home screen. You can see if you're connected to the internet, it will check for a new firmware version. In this case, a new version is available. Tap on the red banner. You can see the changes in the new version listed in the update log. Tap download now. Ain't nobody got time for this. Let's speed this up with some magic in video editing. Once the download is complete, the drone will get updated with the new firmware first. During the update, it's totally normal for the drone to restart a few times. More fast forward magic. After the drone is updated, the remote control comes next. Once this is done, you've updated the firmware on the remote control, on the drone, and the battery that's in the drone. If you have additional batteries, those might have to get upgraded as well. Power everything off, start the update process with each battery, and don't worry, it'll go much quicker. After everything's complete, you'll see this confirmation of the latest version. And now we take a look at how to do the firmware update using the DJI 2 Assistant app on your computer. Grab the DJI Assistant using the link in the YouTube description below. Fire up the DJI Assistant 2 app. Those of you on Windows, this will look very similar. Let's zoom in a bit so you guys can see what I'm doing. Go ahead and plug in the Mavic 2 with its legs unfolded, gimbal clamp removed, and the USB-C cable inserted into the drone. Power on the drone. Click Mavic 2 Pro.
Click Upgrade next to the version you want to upgrade to. Once the download is complete, the firmware package will get transmitted to the drone. Once the transmission is complete, the actual update starts. Success! The drone is updated. Don't forget to update any spare batteries you have. Alright, the remote control's next. Power off the drone, unplug it, and plug in the remote with a micro USB cable. Power it on, and then select Mavic 2 controller. In this case, I was already at the latest version, but I'm going to hit refresh, which re-downloads and reinstalls the firmware version. The order is the same. Download, transmit, and update. Great, the controller is updated.
Great, you've updated the drone, the remote control, the DJI Go 4 app is compatible with the versions on those two things. You're good to go, right? Not so fast. Let's take a look and make sure the settings are correct and do our test flight. All right, you've gone through the settings, you've made sure that your personal settings are back in there if they've gotten overwritten. Your batteries are now fully recharged, both the drone and the remote control. I'd recommend doing a test flight, even if it's a short one, to make sure that the drone behaves as it should. Make sure you recalibrate the compass before the test flight, even if you go back to the same location as the previous flight. Make sure the map correctly shows your location, and take off and do a short test flight. Make sure that pushing the right stick to the right actually makes the drone go to the right, same with all the other controls. If anything is funky at all during the test flight, bring the drone down safely for a nice landing. If everything so far worked out perfectly, great! Now fly the drone a little bit further away to make sure that the transmission strength is still good. If the drone flies great and there's no transmission issues, you've done a very important step in updating the firmware. Alright, time for the question of the day. Have you ever used the DJI Assistant 2 to update your firmware? Or did you run into any issues? Let us know in the comments below, and someone in the community will help you out. Hey, thanks for watching. If that helped you out, hit that like button, and if you want more free resources, head over to the blog.